world, and it has come to our own season. Europe is just coming out of its own season,
yes.
And we are in season, and very soon the dry weather, the rainy season will end and we'll go back to dry weather. It's an inconvenience of a few days aggregating to a few months. It's the same way that you can't live in Europe and say there won't be winter and there won't be snow. And that period is a period of inconvenience. Sometimes you just wake up, you can't go out. There's snow day. So it's not different. So if we had winter here, it would happen instead of flood.
Yes.
And Lagos, people must continue to remember, this place is a place that is a series of so many little islands, close to water, low lying, just barely 2 meters above sea level. So once the flood finishes in Europe,
it's coming this way.
It's the same Atlantic as the Babbage that goes all the way to North America.
Yes.
So, and in the fullness of time, nature will take its course, the tide will recede again, and we'll be happier. So the best thing we want to do here is to ensure that we don't lose lives, as other places have done. They've lost lives in America, in the Philippines, in Australia. The channels, the canals, the drainages, the concrete drainages that we build, the gutters, as people like to call them.
Yes, gutters, let's use that.
They are not the drainages themselves. They are the pathways by which storm water and flood water goes to the ultimate drain. The ultimate drains are the lagoons and the oceans. Every gutter ends up, takes water in a direction that goes to one major canal. And that canal goes either to the lagoon or to the sea. If we choose to use those channels,
yes,
to deposit our waste, we contribute more to the problem. That is, of course, not to say that when there is heavy rainfall, the rainfall as it falls on land falls on the sea and the level rises. So once the level of the sea rises above the level of the gutter, there's no way it's going to go until the sea recedes and then it can drain off. But because of the work that we've done, no matter how bad the rain is,
yes,
when you have 7 hours of uninterrupted heavy storm and in 3-4 hours it goes, I think this government must just be commended for the work that it has done.
Water is a necessity of life. It plays a major role in the daily activities of man, animals, and plants. When it rains, plants, animals, as well as the air gets refreshed from the showers. The problem, however, arises when it rains heavily for a long period of time. This leads to flood. Flooding is a natural event or occurrence where a piece of land or area that is usually dry suddenly gets submerged. Sometimes, flood occurs suddenly and recedes quickly, while others take days or even months to build and discharge. Flood is extremely dangerous and has the potential to wipe away an entire city, coastline, or area, and can cause extensive damage to life and property. Flood can occur as a result of spring snowmelt, severe thunderstorms, prolonged rains, inadequate drainage facilities, or failure of levees and dams, rapid population growth, poor governance, decaying infrastructures, lack of proper environmental planning and management strategies. The poor practice of dumping refuse and climate change have been traced amongst other human activities as factors that accelerate the rate of this disaster, which often leaves in its wake the spread of disease, loss of lives and properties.
We as Nigerians, we should be able to help the government too. Like, you know, during rainy season, we don't have to put our debt into the flood. You know, some people do it. They put their debts when it's raining. They pour their, instead of them to use their dustbin to keep it, then the other Loma people, they will come and take it away. But they will pour it into the flood, which is not really helping at all.
My message goes to the people out there. You know, like what I saw today in some part of Lagos is an eyesore. I look at people, you know, putting debris on the road simply because rain is falling, just to shine the debris away. So majorly what we are experiencing in Lagos, in some part of Lagos, is human factor. You know, they cause 25% of what is the flooding that is happening in Lagos. So I think we employ people too much, you know, on keeping the debris to the Loma.
According to the 2011 United Nations Worldwide Water Statistics, there has been a rapid growth in the number of people killed or properties seriously damaged by flood disasters. The economic damages affect mostly a large proportion of people living in low-lying coastal zones or other areas at risk of flooding and extreme weather conditions. The United Nations statistics clarified that flood causes half of the disasters worldwide and 84% disaster deaths in Africa. Flooding caused by extremely heavy rains in January of 2015 affected several countries in Africa, leaving scores of people dead, many displaced and several properties damaged. Countries such as Malawi, Mozambique, Madagascar, Zimbabwe, South Africa, amongst others, were all affected. Lagos was not left out of this situation. The state with an estimated population of over 21 million people is a low-lying coastal region occupying 180 kilometers of Nigeria's coastline. It covers approximately 3,577 square kilometers, which represents 0.45% of Nigeria's territorial landmass. Lagos State drains two-thirds of southwest Nigeria and is characterized by wetlands and basins for five major upstream rivers from neighboring states which discharge into the Atlantic Ocean. The topography of the state harbors about 78% water bodies of various sizes, such as the ocean, lagoons, lakes, streams, and wetland, amongst others. To address the issues of flooding in the state, Lagos under former governor Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu created the Office of Drainage Services in 2005. The office was carved out from the Ministry of the Environment. The responsibilities of the Drainage Department include formulation and implementation of policy on storm water management and to ensure that the incidence of flooding in Lagos State is reduced and controlled to an appreciable level, monitoring and prevention of illegal developments on natural and built storm water drainage alignments and water catchment areas, identification of flooding problems and flood-prone areas, subsequent formulation and implementation of projects to resolve identified problems, formulation of policies, plans, procedures and rules for provision of storm water drainage channels, including technical assistance to all other executing agencies providing storm water drainage and protection of wetlands and natural drainage alignments. To ensure efficiency and see that every Lagosian guards against flooding in the state, the office embarked on adaptive and mitigative efforts to reduce the effect of floods in the state. Massive cleaning, dredging of canals and drainage channels, as well as provision of efficient drainage system for easy flow of water has been major actions taken by the government.
I think they are trying. At least they are clearing gutters, canals, but I believe they need to educate the people more on the need for them not to litter, not to fill up those canals, those gutters already cleared, how to be environmental friendly.
I would say that it's been great. We've seen the effort of the government in clearing drainages along the canals. Periodically, we find them moving around places and with the workers trying to clean the drainages. Worthy of commendation is the enlightenment program, the carry on in trying to educate people as to the danger of dumping refuses along our drainage way. So that has gone a long way in helping people to know that they have responsibility, part to play in preventing flood in their areas.
I think the government should do more. The government should educate us, educate the citizens more on keeping the environment clean and their drainages cleared as much as possible. They should also help us with facilities also that will help with the drainages cleared all the time. I discovered that they try to clear, but the more they clear, the more people actually putting things back. So maybe they need to do a lot of enforcement to ensure that drainages are kept clean all season.
The drainage maintenance program led to the desilting of major channels in all 20 local government councils and the 37 local county development areas across the state. There has also been an increase in the dredging of primary channels and secondary collectors across the state. Massive expansion of existing drainage channels to accommodate higher volume of storm water and the excavation of silt and filth are also steps taken to ensure a flood-free state.
I've seen some canals where they are being kind of working, they are dredging the riverine areas, all those swampy areas, you know, to make sure that the water is flowing the right way it's supposed to.
We should generally keep our environments flood-free, keep our environments, you know, neat, so that the drainage can go very well. Lagos State government is really trying, and they are working towards, you know, preventing hazards during the time of flooding.
By cleaning up our environments, opening our drainages, and making sure our drainages are clean and without any restriction of water flow.
The state intensified its massive dredging, desilting and maintenance of primary and secondary collectors across the state in areas such as Oba Ogunji Road, Ifakwa Ijai, the Industrial Road in Ikorodu, Agege Moto Road, Moshalashi, Mushi, Ashimou, Bakari and Lawansin Street in Mushi, Ishaga Road, also in Mushi, Odogunyo in Ikorodu, Mobalaji Bank Anthony Way in Ikeja, Oyekon and Queen's Barracks in Apapa, Eku Akete Collector in Amuodofi, Jankara and Binuyo on Lagos Island, NNPC in Ejigbo, Oshodi Solo, Alidada Street in Oshodi Solo, and Adeyemo Alakija Street in Victoria Island, amongst several others.
There is a great improvement compared to before, because most of the time when I go into the metropolis like Apapa, where I actually stay, most of the gutters are cleared. At times I wonder, who are the people doing this? Well, regardless of whether it's the local government that is doing it or the state government, whoever is doing it, I believe that it is Lagos State that is working.
Utmost attention has also been given to rehabilitation and expansion of drainage channels to ensure free flow of water. The channels include Agboroko Channel in Lasu Ojo Campus, Adialu Street Collector, Elere Channel, the rail line Agumbiade and Owo Channel, Balogun Ilawe and Swiffer Channel, Powa Shopping Complex to Okekoto, Abatio to Oladoje Trapezoidal, the Katangua and Okuoba Canal and Akilo Road channels in Ajeromi Ifelodu Local Government, Mba and Kadoso Streets, Tolu Road, Akran, Osho Drive, Oguniyi, Alafia Street and Tin Can Coconut Drain Collector Drains were also maintained. In Alimosho Local Government, the same was done on Ishefun Road, Potokun, Karimulaka, Bamishile Road, Jimo Akiremi, Shasha Akunwojo and Egbeda, Isheri Ijegun Road, Abaranje, amongst others. The drainage channels in Ogba, Isheri and Ijegun Roads, to mention a few, had also been constructed.
From the point, from the look of things, Lagos government is really trying. I can bear that with you. They are really trying, and they are doing all, you know, they are trying all their possible best to say that, you know, we don't have flood in Lagos. And I strongly commend them for that, and I'm happy with what is really happening, you know, at the moment.
The Lagos State Government has followed up with routine maintenance of existing drainage channels and construction of new ones, as well as initiating other measures and projects to deal with the menace of flood across Lagos. Current prediction by the Nigerian Meteorological Agency, NIMET, for the year 2015 has revealed that the state would experience 260 days of rainfall, with the maximum annual rainfall pegged at 1.824 millimeters. The reports further states that the high temperature and humidity would give rise to pests and vectors which spread diseases. This can only be curbed by ensuring that the environment is clean so as to minimize the effects of mosquitoes.
No matter how the rain will fall, people will definitely be affected, but it will be reduced if they take the pain to ensure that their drainage are cleared, all the drain ducts and the debris are not thrown in the waterway, in the gutter. Your surroundings are kept clean. When those are done, definitely they will. The water, when it falls, it will have a place to pass to, and before you know it, everything will be okay.
I have to ensure that my environment is clean, and I have to properly dispose my refuse. Because at the end of the day, what constitutes flood is when refuse are not properly disposed. Maybe you pile them up and put them by the roadside, and when it starts raining, it goes back into the drainage. And at the end of the day, it's still harmful to us because it will block the drainage. Then the water that is supposed to flow freely will not have access to flow freely, and it comes back to us. So it's just like pennywise, pound foolish. My environment has to be clean at all times, properly clean. Then my refuse must be properly disposed. That's using the waste management services.
It is therefore of utmost importance that Lagos residents cooperate with the state government in its concerted effort to fight floods by properly disposing their waste in designated areas and desist from dumping refuse into canals, as well as refrain from erecting structures on or along drainage channels.
We are prepared. We've got information and we are prepared already. But to some people that are not aware, it's all about sensitizing them, letting them know that dumping refuse indiscriminately cannot help the issue because it will end up blocking the canal and water pathways, which will make water to leave East Bank, then enter their residential areas.
One should just try and get certain things in order. It depends on where you live. I don't live in a waterlogged area, as it were, but for those of us who do, I would suggest that people should try and stop this throwing of dirt in gutters, because most times you find that when it rains in some areas, people tend to empty their refuse in the gutters because they believe the heavy rainfall or the flood will like move the dirt away for them. The rain becomes lummer. So I guess that should stop.
As a proactive and responsive government, Governor Babatunde Fashola's administration, through the Ministry of the Environment, has put in place measures to reduce the incidence of flooding in the state and curtail its impact to the barest minimum. Planting to greening projects, monthly environmental exercises, climate change programs, wastewater and waste management, the Lagos State Government have not rested on its oars to create a healthy and sustainable environment for the people to live and to thrive.